Hello everybody, welcome back to Little Annie Kitchen. There were some of my subscribers who wanted me to do a Punjabi cuisine. So today I am making a Amritsari aloo kulcha. Of course it's 100% veg and it's so delicious to make. Why not get started? But wait, before that, like and subscribe to my channel and also share your comments in the comment section below that which cuisine like and what recipes you want me to post
from. I will add 2 cups of all-purpose flour, that's maida. This is 1 and 2. After that, I'll add the salt, 1/2 teaspoon again. Then I will add 2 teaspoons of sugar, 1, 2. After that, I will also add 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, not soda, powder. Then after that, I'll also add some curd. As you're making a kulcha, not a roti, so I will add around 3 tablespoons of curd. Next, you will also add 1 teaspoon of ghee. You can add butter also. And last, I will add water to make the dough. I will just give all of them a good mix. Before adding the water, the dough should already start forming a structure. Now, I will add the water gradually. In the end, I'll tell you how much water I used. Add the water. Mix, mix, mix. Our dough should form a sticky dough, a really sticky dough, and that's what we want. We don't want a stiff dough. So just again, keep kneading. Again, add the water. And knead it again. So the dough should be very sticky, and I've added 3/4 cup of water, that's around 180 ml. Now we've covered this with the muslin cloth and let it rest for 30 minutes. Meanwhile, we will also prepare our filling. You can take 5 to 6 boiled potatoes and we have to crush them in our hand and put them in a bowl. For that, I will add kasuri methi. That's around 1 teaspoon of kasuri methi. Then 1 chopped onion. This is finely chopped, remember. After that, around 1 tablespoon of coriander, that's chopped. Then 1 teaspoon of amchur powder, as it gives tanginess. Then I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of chili powder, and I will add rock salt in this. I will add around 1/4 teaspoon because it's pretty strong. And lastly, I will just add around 1/4 teaspoon of ghee. Just 1/4 teaspoon, and we will mix that. It smells really good. All the spices coming together, giving a nice aroma. We have to make it very creamy. I'll show you how creamy should it be, like this. Should easily spread in your hand. So we'll keep mixing until it's super creamy. I will set that aside. Here I have 1.5 tablespoon mix of roasted coriander and cumin seeds. I'll put this onto the chakla. I'll take the rolling pin and I'll start crushing it. Can you hear that sound? It's very satisfying. Keep crushing it because crushing it helps to bring a lot of flavor in the kulcha. And the smell is very good. So that's almost done. And now I'll just add it to the aloo mixture. I will add 2 to 3 tablespoons of dry maida, as this will help in removing all the moisture that was in the potatoes. Keep mixing. And you will also start to feel on your hands that it gets less sticky because all the moisture has been removed and been soaked in the maida. So the dough has been resting for 30 minutes. Now I need to add 4 tablespoons of dry flour because the dough was very sticky. Then go in with your hands and start kneading again. Keep kneading and the dough will turn very soft now at this point. That's why we had made the dough sticky earlier, so it would turn pretty soft after it had rested for 30 minutes. And the next step, what we have to do is layering. So it's like a puff pastry layering we have to do. We have to just kind of spread the dough like this. Okay? Then we will add, first we'll add 1 tablespoon of softened butter. spread that kind of equally. Then take this like and fold it and start kneading it again. Then again add 1 tablespoon of butter. So again repeat the process.
So we have to keep kneading the dough for around 5 minutes. Later the kulchas will be ready to be stuffed with the aloo mixture, and of course later I'll eat it also a little bit. Now just a taste test so that I can tell you guys how it tastes.
So we will take a small ball size dough, spread it with your hands. Then we will take the potato filling and put it in this. Then put that in the middle and then start sealing it very gently and a little carefully. Just take it like this.
So I've rolled out the kulcha. Now I'll just take some water and we have to spread the water on the kulcha so that it sticks on the tawa later. So I'll put it onto the hot tawa. And now we'll put it on sim flame or low flame until little very very small bubbles start to approach here. Then we will flip it onto the stove. I'll show you how evenly it turns brown and crispy. So as you can see, it will start to turn a little brown, and we want it to be very brown and crispy but not black.
The Amritsari Kulcha is ready, and now I'm just spreading some butter because there is no Amritsari Kulcha without any butter. So I'm just adding around a tablespoon of butter. So spread that and be careful, it's a little hot. After that, we're gonna add some chopped coriander for freshness and some dry kasuri methi. And now I just try to take some of it. And also, we have one surprise, okay? We have complimentary chole. Now just take. Okay, I'm not able to take also. So I'll just take one and I'll try. It was so yummy. It was so delicious. So of course, do not forget to try this recipe out, okay? And like and subscribe my channel. Bye.